So, I was talking today with a girlfriend, and we were talking about availability. Now, availability is something that I really love, to be quite honest with you. I spend a lot of time working with clients, teaching in my classes, in moon circles, etc., etc., and speaking to the wisdom of being available. My little man back there, which is perfect that he's back there while I'm recording this video because this is about availability, but it's also about an expression of motherhood. And I'll get into how that shakes out in just a minute. So I love availability. In fact, availability is honestly one of the sexiest words for me. And it's delicious, it's juicy, it's truth in my opinion. And I think all of those things. And I speak to all of these things when I teach or when I work with clients because one of the biggest missteps that humanity makes is being as egocentric as we are. And what I mean specifically by that is I think that we should wake up every single morning and before we even get out of our beds, say our prayers. You know, send our light, send our love, whatever verbiage you want to use, I don't really care. But make ourselves available to the wisdom of the universe, to the energetics that are everywhere. And so, from a Course in Miracles standpoint, I don't know if anyone is familiar with that body of work. I'm sure you are. It's an incredible piece of work. From a Course in Miracles standpoint, one of the things that it talks about is the morning prayer, the opening prayer that says, "Where would you have me go? What would you have me do? What would you have me say, and to whom?" And that is such a beautiful essence of availability because I know that we all have our agendas, we all have our to-do lists, we all have the things that we think we need to accomplish based on the goals that we have decided are important, based on our priorities and our headspace. That is all very egoic, to be quite honest with you. And there's nothing wrong with that. Yes, please, have a hustle, have goals, work after it. Yes. And be available for the mystery. Be available for what might actually want to come your way. You know, how often have we had these days or these experiences where we're like, "Oh, nothing is going my way." Well, shit, man, because your way was not the way for that day. So if we can work on better aligning our way with the way, like capital T, the way, whatever that way is, I personally find there to be a hell of a lot more harmony and truth and lightness and enjoyment in my life when I'm available for whatever it is that the universe wants to send my way. Just as much as we may get frustrated with, "Oh, the day isn't going my way," there also have been incredible moments where we're like, "Oh my God, I can't believe that happened today. I can't believe I met him today. I got a raise today. I got that job offer today." There are so many beautiful things that can show up. So it's not all about good or bad. Again, you know, it's very Taoist in nature. There is no good or bad, it just is. And what is most important to allow us to be accepting of the is when we are available. All of that being said, the context of what my girlfriend and I were talking about today had to do with availability as it pertains to men and women, right? I've been making all these videos about masculine and feminine energy, the interaction between men and women. And one of the things that is like, to be honest with you, some stupid ass rule that's out there is like, you can't be too available. And I don't care whether that's a man, a woman. Again, I don't, has nothing to do with identification or what type of persuasion you like in your relationships. It doesn't matter. There's this weird rule in dating around don't be too available. I am such a no to that. To be honest with you, I am such a no to that. And I've always, this is just my own personal perspective, I've always been a no to the game playing and the rules. And but if I do this, it'll make them think that. Well, oh my Lord, I just have no time for that. I have no time, nor do I want to invest my energy in that way. Wherever I am, that's where I am, and that's where I want to be. Because if we are going to be in a relationship, you're gonna be dealing with me wherever I am in any given moment. So, you know, this don't be too available, you know, play it cool, play hard to get. Oh, gross. For me, I'm sorry, that is very small-minded and not human. Not human, because anytime we have to set those types of limitations or restrictions within a relationship, we withhold our genuine nature. We withhold our humanity. We withhold our magic. Because we want to be in relationship. We are a relationship-based creature. We are all connected already anyways, and we really seek to get back to that connection. And I talked about that, I don't know, one of these, I don't know, bottom line, you know, this connection that we want with each other, it starts with our connection with self. So why on earth would I try and act as if I'm something that I'm not? Why on earth would I act as if I'm not interested in you if I am? Why on earth would I act like I don't want to see you when I do? Lots of times this shows up in relationships because there will be these conversations around how being too available becomes unattractive. And I call bullshit on that. I'm a no to that. Especially speaking as a female and speaking from this predominantly feminine energy place. Now, getting back to that masculine and feminine energy, inevitably, based on the way that feminine energy interacts with the world, again, thinking about that idea of how feminine energy holds space, how feminine energy kind of like holds the community, holds the tribe, holds the family, holds the house. Whatever physical human representations you want to utilize, just how feminine energy holds space and interprets and understands its value by its relationship and its connection to everything around it. Inevitably and inherently, feminine energy is available. And that ties to motherhood because as a mother to human children, we must always be available for them. End of story. We must always be available for them. You never know what it is that they're going to bring to you in any given moment. You never know what kind of mood they're going to be in. You never know, you know, they might wake up on the wrong side of the bed and all of a sudden it's just one of them days. And if you have children, you know that to be true. Sometimes you're just like, yo, everything that was going to happen today is not happening because the kids are not about it. And that doesn't need to apply just to people who have children. The essence of motherhood as an extension of feminine energy, like right now I'm trying to record this, and even though I told him to please be quiet, he's being real loud. The essence of motherhood as an extension of feminine energy is about being available for whatever comes your way. Not only what comes your way in the world outside of you, but what comes your way in terms of how you're feeling on the day? How are you going to hold space for yourself? How are you going to nurture yourself? How are you going to be available for how your energy presents that particular day, that particular moment after said thing that you are not expecting to occur occurs in your life? We rock our motherhood energy. We rock our motherhood expression, whether we have human children or not. Motherhood has, I don't want to say nothing to do. Motherhood is not exclusive to just human children. And this speaks to that essential feminine program that I work with women on. That's always one of the biggest things is they'll look at it and like, okay, yeah, cool. Spirituality. Yep. Cool. Sexuality. Yep. Cool. Sisterhood. Yep. Cool. Motherhood. Oh, I don't have kids. I'm like, wow, that's not what this is about. That is some of it. But that's not what this is about. Motherhood energy has to do again with how we receive ourselves and each other, how we nurture ourselves and each other, how available we are for ourselves and each other. And guess what, y'all? With a feminine essence, inevitably, you are going to be more available. You just are. And I will parlay that over to my folks who present and identify more as masculine, because again, as energetic bundles, we all have both. We have masculine and feminine energy. Your feminine energy also exists. Therefore, your motherhood expression or fatherhood expression, if that's going to feel better for you, will show up as well in terms of how available are you for yourself? How do you nurture yourself? How do you receive yourself? Again, we're not limited to just the bodies that we're in, the anatomy, the gender, the identification. These are energetic expressions that live in all things. So this idea of don't be too available, why am I so available? It's unattractive if someone's unavailable. Well, listen, if it's unattractive to you that someone is too available, there's something to be learned there. That is the nature of any trigger, of anything. When we are feeling a conflict or a resistance around something, that's because there's some type of unhealed, resistant thing inside of you. Because it is very possible to be turned off by how available someone is. And that doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with you, but there is the option for you to say to that person or to communicate to that person, hey, listen, this just isn't a good fit, right? And we do that with respect and with communication to one another. We can be not a match for somebody, but out of respect for their humanity and for them just as a human being to say, hey, you know, this job isn't a good fit. We're gonna go with a different person to rent the apartment. You know, you're really great, but I don't wanna continue dating you. I mean, whatever it is, whatever the context or the scenario is, always, always communication, communication, communication is important and available to us. If we have done our work, if we are comfortable with our expression, with our feminine softness, our masculine expression. And a lot of that shows up in how available we are. How available we are for our experiences, for our emotions, which therefore make us available for the experiences and the emotions of other people. So, all of that being said, I'm curious to know what availability means to you. How does it feel to think about waking up in the morning and offering yourself in that 80-20 way, that 80% feminine, starting your day with like, okay, I'm here, I'm awake, I'm alive, I am the vessel. What is it that wants to come through me today? What is it that I can do to be of service? Like, where am I needed in the grand scheme of things in this world? You know, every cell in our body has a particular job to do, a particular role to play for the functioning of this whole organism, and we are a cell on the organism of Earth, and we all have a particular role to play, an assignment, an area that we are intended for. And when people are so desirous of wanting to find their purpose, it starts with being available. It starts with backing off, zooming out a little bit, and taking stock of what are the things that you just naturally do so well? What are the things that people come to you for constantly? What are the things that light up your body? Because the answer to all of those questions will lead you to that sense of purpose and that connection to your purpose. And I also want to add to that, that our purpose and our role on this planet is not limited to the job that we do to pay our bills. You can do you can rock your purpose no matter what container that you're in. So sometimes it does involve shifting your career and heading in a different trajectory. Other times it's about shifting your perspective and putting your headspace into a different trajectory. All of those are very human, real world, or I guess physical world examples of how we are available and how we rock our sense of motherhood, parenting, nurturing, receiving. It's not, you know, fatherhood and motherhood is not fatherhood, motherhood. Something about that doesn't sound weird in my mouth today, sorry. It's not just about having human kids at all. You know, we do a lot of parenting for our communities. And in essence, when it comes to healing those old childhood wounds and those traumas and those things that do trigger you when it comes to how you're interacting and relating to other people, we end up reparenting ourselves. We end up giving to ourselves the motherhood or the fatherhood that we didn't get as young people, as little ones, because our parents had their own limitations, their own wounds, their own things that they were working through. So my invitation, as always, is to spend some time thinking about how available you are. And why you maybe aren't more available, or why you maybe are too available. And those more and two words are completely, you know, specific to each person. It just depends on what your bandwidth, what your truth is, what your alignment is. Thanks for hanging out for a little bit. I love you.